Hello class, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Let's start the class. Today's topic is tenses. After this class, children, you will be able to learn about tenses and how to use simple present tense while writing or speaking. So let's start. Tenses, you know, children, they play a very important role in English language. It denotes the time an action takes place, whether sometime in the past, present, or will take sometime in future. That means that it will tell you that when action is happening, whether it is happening somewhere in the past or right now or sometime in the future. So that is why it is important to know more about the tenses. Basically, you should understand that tenses denotes time of an action. Today we are going to learn more about simple present tense. Children, we use simple present tense to show the regular habits or the daily routines. You know, when we are in the habit of doing something on the regular basis, we use simple present tense. Those actions which we used to do, which we can say our habit is, they can be our habit, a hobby, a daily event, or something that often happens. For example, you see, I play soccer. That means I am in the habit of playing soccer. The school opens every morning at 7 a.m. Of course, it is the everyday habit, it is the routine that it opens every day at 7. He always forgets her bag. That means he is always in the habit of forgetting his bag. So it is his daily routine or his habit, or he is doing it on the daily basis. Right, children? It also tells us more about the facts or generalizations, or you can say the universal truths, which will remain the same for everyone, which never change. For example, cats like milk. You know, children, if I say that cats like milk, it is in India also, they like milk. Or in any other part of the globe you go, they will always remain the same. The fact will always remain the same that cats like milk. Windows are not made of wood. So, or we can say, we can take one more example. Water freezes at 0 degrees Celsius. So you can see that these are some of the facts or the universal truth which cannot change. Yes. So simple present tense can also indicate the speaker believes that in fact was true before, it is true now and will be true in future also. It also tells us about the events that is going to happen somewhere in the very near future, which is going to happen means in a very short duration of time. For example, the bus leaves tonight at 6 p.m. That means the bus is about to leave tonight itself. Very short duration of time is there. When do we board the plane? The party starts at 8 o'clock. Now I'm going to tell you certain rules, children, how to write the sentences in simple present tense. Make sure, children, we are going to use simple rule by adding S to the verb 1 when we are using a singular subject, or you can say the third person singular, that is he, she, it. So whenever we are using these, we are going to use S with verb 1. For example, he lives, she lives. Can you see, children, that we are adding live as a verb 1. So we are adding S to it because the subject is singular, that is he. As you know, there is a rule for changing, adding S or IES with the verbs. So this is the rules for that. How can you add S or IES? If the word generally ends, you know, in general, we use only S with the verb 1. But if the verb ends with Y, we will add IES in place of Y. And if it ends in O, SH, TCH, X, SS, or these, any of these, we use ES with it. For example, you can see study becomes studies. IES is added because Y is at the end. Same way, go becomes goes because it ends with O. Spy becomes spies. Mix becomes mixes because it ends with X. So see children, these are some of the rules which you can keep in mind when you are changing the verb one by adding S or IES or ES. Now let's recap. We use simple present tense to talk about facts, habits or routines. For example, I live in Poland is a fact. It is not going to be changed. Same way you can say that I live in Delhi. Your habit or routines, they swim every day. It is their habit or it is their routine, which they used to do it on the regular basis. Feeling or emotions, like they like pizza. So that is their feeling, you know, they like pizza. Or general truth, which you can say as universal truth, Sunday comes after Saturday. So it remains the same whether you are here or somewhere else. Now children, you have to write these sentences in simple present tense. Like, he goes to school. Can you see that ES is added because? Yes, you're correct. The subject is singular. The third person, that is he. They eat. So they eat a lot. Because it is plural, so we will only use verb 1. I repeat children, if you are writing a sentence in a simple present tense and the singular subject is there, you will add S, ES or IES according to the rules we have read. But if it is plural subject or with I, we always use only verb 1. Like they is a plural subject, so we use only verb 1, that is eat. She serve. So we are making a sentence. She serves the internet. Can you see the S added to the verb serve? Yes. Just because that the subject is singular. So I hope you understand all these. We will meet again. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.